Ladies and gentlemen, it's a pleasure to be here this today. My apologies for the delay. I had another event at Holiday Inn, so I had to do some opening at 11 o'clock, so I got delayed. I want to thank you all for waiting. As you know, our Honourable Prime Minister is very particular about serving the people in the Interior and Maritime Division. Honourable Prime Minister wants us ministers, our officers, to come out and see how you are living here, what problems you are facing, how we can assist you, how we can improve your life, how your children can be assisted so that they can get good quality education, better health facilities, road, water, electricity. Today, I'm humbled to be here. I've never been here. I've been to a lot of places when I was Minister of Education, and then the Minister for Waterways and Environment, and now Agriculture and Rural and Maritime. But for some reason, I was not able to come here to Nambukkalev. So it's a blessing today that I'm here to see you all, and also to see you in good spirits, good mood. You know, thank you very much. I want to assure you on behalf of our Prime Minister, Honourable Joshua Waringe Manimarama, that you are not forgotten. You are out of our sight, but you're not out of our mind. The other interior communities, other people who stay in the Maritime Division, Yasawas, the Lao Group, Vidya, etc., you're not forgotten. When we had this TC Sarai 2 weeks ago, immediately government responded by sending a boat with relief supplies to people in Kandavu. There was no delay. This is how we are there to respond to your immediate needs. Today we are here to have a talanoa with you. I want to assure you that we are ready to support you. As I was coming up the road to this place, I saw a lot of good land, good arable land that could be utilized for agriculture. I understand that you're doing very good yamana farming. We can further assist on that. I understand you're doing yam farming. We can further assist on that. At the moment, we are re-looking and restructuring our agro-marketing authority. And I want to assure you that you get into the production, you supply, you don't have to worry about looking for the market. We can come and pick it up from here. Our agro-marketing authority can come and pick it up from here once a week. We'll come, we'll weigh, we'll pay you in 3 days' time, we'll take your produce. So you don't have to worry about coming all the way to Nabua or Suva market. We will, that's the purpose of agro-marketing authority. We have established agro-marketing authority is to bring the market to you. You don't go to the market. Saying, I don't have to worry. You are spending a lot of money in hiring a vehicle, a van, a pickup to take your one bag of yam or, 10 kg of kava, and then you collect and you get together. Don't have to do that. We can schedule a visit. I understand that you are putting your land under forestry, which is very good, good for the country, good for future. But there will also some land which you can further expand for cover production. We want to support that. We want to assist you in that. Very soon, we will be introducing announcing a new project where we want to assist you to clear the land to bring more land under production. So it's a new package that we pick up the expenses of land clearing, we'll clear the land, we will assist you in preparing the land, and then we'll provide you with the planting material, and then you do the planting. So we will announce that, and we want to offer you that so that you can bring more land under production. Don't worry about where you will sell it. That's not your problem. That's our problem. We bring the market to you. We'll buy all your cover. We'll buy all your yam. So we are very happy that you're doing good Yangwana production. I'll ask the agricultural officer to talk to you and let us know how many area of land, how many acres of land that you want to clear. We will come and clear it for you. We'll bring the machine. Right? No cost to you. Zero cost. So whether it's 100 acre or 200 acre, let's do it in steps. Let's say we can do 50 acre first, and we will clear it for you. You can plant Yangwana or yam, and then we will buy it of you. We'll buy it of you. Our price may be slightly less than the price you get in Nabua or Suba, but you don't have to worry about transportation cost. You don't have to, you take your produce to Nabua. When they see a truckload of Yangwana, they'll say, sorry, today we already bought, so maybe your price is very low. No, that's not good. They know that you've already come there. You have no choice but to accept their price. They'll play around with you. But that won't happen with us. We will be honest. Agro Marketing Authority will give you a price, and that's the price we'll adhere to. Same thing with yam. We want you to plant the variety of yam that we recommend. We recommend a variety that is wanted by export in New Zealand or Australia. That's the variety we'll promote. So we'll give you the seedling. We'll give you the seedling. The other crop that we are promoting and for export market is cassava. There's a lot of demand for yellow cassava, Benga yellow cassava. We'll get you the planting material. We'll get you the planting material. You plant the Benga yellow cassava, and we will buy it off you and we'll export it to New Zealand and Australia. In Australia, the Indonesians prefer yellow cassava. So we will get back to you regard to planting material. We are expanding the planting material at Cornibia and also at Dombolo. So we will get you the planting material. So with these words, I want to thank you very much, and I want to talk about a few other issues before I get to the main issue that we are here today. The other issues that I want to talk to is about the plastic ban. As you know, we are protecting our environment. We want, like you are enjoying this nice environment, we want your children, your grandchildren, your great-great-children also to benefit from this kind of environment. At the moment, if you come to Suva, Nindi, Lutoka, you see a lot of rubbish thrown alongside the road, alongside the beach, in the mangrove, plastic waste. We need to have pride for our country. We need to protect our environment. We need to look after our environment. Who is creating that rubbish? Who is throwing that rubbish? It's us. So we are creating a problem. The solution lies with us, not with government. We are there to support you. So we want to urge you all that you support the plastic ban that Honorable Minister for Economy, Honorable Syed Kayyum, has announced. I'm asking you all to rally behind and support. I must say that entire Fiji is now adjusting their consumption practice, so that they're not using the single-use plastic bag. And eventually we'll end up banning all plastic bags because we want our environment to be safe. Plastics will be there forever, ages and ages, hundreds and hundreds of years. It does not degenerate, unlike paper bags. So we want to do away with plastic bags. Similarly, we have banned two chemicals, Cremexone and Imidachloroprid. Imidachloroprid, that particular insecticide, was used to control insects, but it also killed bees. So it was counterproductive because we were promoting bee farming. So we can't be allowing a chemical which is killing the bees. So we have banned that from 1st of January, so it won't be available. You need to use alternative chemicals, alternative organic chemicals, which we are promoting. Secondly, Gramexone has a lot of health effect. People can't breathe properly. People are having lesions because it doesn't affect you immediately. It'll affect you in 5 years' time, 10 years' time, 20 years' time. When you become old, you will have lots of problems. incidence of cancer is increasing. So that's why we have banned Cremexone. Of course, the other issue is a lot of people are committing suicide by consuming it. And also it has impact on crop residue, on the groundwater contamination, because it leaches down. We are a small country. We are pouring in millions of liters of chemicals in Fiji. So we are undertaking a major review of all the chemicals that we are getting into the country, whether we can have an alternative, an organic alternative. We really can't be pouring chemicals which will, at the end of the day, will come back and end up in our food. So that's why we want to ban the use of chemicals as far as possible. So at the moment, the review is being undertaken. We may not ban all, we may not ban any, or we may ban all. You see, but as long as we get a substitute to deal with the issue or problem that these chemicals are dealing. So we're undertaking a review, a study now. So I want to thank you all for supporting the plastic ban that Honorable Minister of Economy has announced. I want to thank you all for supporting our announcement that from 1st of January, we have banned the use of Cremexone and imidacloprid. Similarly, we will come back to you about other chemicals. You are all feel free to submit, make submissions through your advisory counselor, Nikoro, feel free to make submissions on the chemical review. Ladies and gentlemen, today we are here for very good news for the villagers. The good news is the completion of the construction of the food crossing. If we had engaged a private contractor to do the food crossing, it would have cost us around 60,000-70,000, nothing less than that. But we did it at our using our own material, own labor, own engineer, and I want to thank in particular the support from the, you know, amazing support, how you looked after our staff, how you provided them with food, did their washing. I really appreciate that, because really, we could have hired a contractor. If we would have hired a contractor, then we can't do that number of food crossing throughout Fiji. At the moment, in the first phase, we have announced to do 52 food crossing. Some of this food crossing, the request was from 10 years ago, 12 years ago, 14 years ago. We have now decided we will do it. Why? Because even though this may be 30,000, maybe 40,000, maybe 50,000. But it matters a lot for the villagers. It matters a lot for our mothers to work in the night from one house to the other, from the community hall to there, from the church, etc. It matters a lot to our children who want to go to school. It matters a lot for our children, farmers who want to go to the farm. And I want to tell you that we are here. We are here to hear you. We want to know how we can assist you to make your life comfortable, particularly our mothers and children who are working very hard silently. Our mothers are working two shift. Our gents, our males, we work hard in the daytime and then we rest. But our mothers, they work hard in the daytime, then the evening they start cooking, then washing, then, you know, feeding the family, then tidying the house, they sleep. The same time as you sleep, but the difference is, you have Talanoa and group, they work hard. I want to thank them. I want to thank them. No, thank them. They are the pillar of strength of our house. They work very hard. And then they wake up early morning to prepare for the children's lunch, breakfast, their bag, iron their clothes, get them ready for the school. So we are really particular, we want to support our mothers, and we're happy to hear from them. The crossing that we have made, it's your call. Your advisory counselor, your friendly quarrel, you have asked, and that crossing may be a small one. In this case, in our scale, it's a bit bigger than the one we have done a few other places. But it connects you. It connects you. Connects you from one area to the other area. One house to the other area. one community to the other community. It means a lot. Whenever there is a connection, it means a lot. Connection by phone, connection by vehicle, connection by road, connection by bridge. Bridges are there to bring people together. And I want to thank you all for waiting for this long. But I want to tell you that our Honorable Prime Minister is very particular in terms of getting quickly to you the services, the assistance, the support. People who live in Suva urban area, in Nandi town, in Latoka, they don't know how life is here, how some of the things that they are taking for granted, but you know, you are content with. And that is why we want to give you priority. We want to give you, bring you at least the basics. Sometimes, you know, in there, we press one button on the wall, light comes. That's not how it happens in the rural interior maritime. So I want to assure you that you are not forgotten. We are here to support you. And our Honorable Prime Minister, our entire cabinet, we are ready to support you. That is why the Honorable Prime Minister and Honorable Minister for Economy announced the establishment of a separate ministry, Ministry for Waterways and Environment. Because waterways is very important for interior communities. Your life is linked to the rivers and streams, entire life. And we need to look after the waterways. At the moment, no one thinks about waterways because it's there. You take it as given. But we have to protect our waterways. We need to look after our waterways. Our life, your life is linked to the waterways. When I was coming up and then down, I saw a nice waterfall on the left. Waterfall, a creek, a river, you know. Fresh water is God given. You're fortunate. Look after it. So it's a pleasure to be here. I look forward to commissioning that wood crossing. Again, I want to thank our engineers, Rajiv, and who was the other people? Timothy, Joe, are they here? Yeah. Timothy, so stand up, Timothy and Joe. Kere. Yeah, I think the village people know them. Timothy and Joe, thank you for the help. Timothy and Joe they design it, they construct it. And and it's not only this foot crossing. Throughout Fiji, the construction of foot crossings, and you know, they are the two most very skilled staff that we have. We're very lucky to have them. I want to thank them for their contribution in getting this constructed. Again, Ninia told me, the support from the villagers was overwhelming to look after our staff. Thank you very much. If they did some mischief, then tell me, we'll deal with them. Naka, thank you.
Lisa, how are you?
Naka.
Lima. Okay. Naka.
You brought in the great sword. Stand here and take the picture. See the fella look like that. Now you can have the river at the background and all.
Right.
Head in there. 1, 2, 3.
Another one.
Yang kita tahu, Epram Navali. Ya turang ni abu sah ini rara nama kelip beruntung.
Vali mulu membelasi na viva terus lagi tak kini buah bu me mendole bena minister na hingga lebih niku.
Kena kau nali gumarau. Mungkin awak na sesi bukir na viva terus lagi kontak ku me ada nali mandurara. Singa niku. Kena viva terus lagi tak kini buah mandu bapa kau kani mandu boleh numi mai. Na tanda kuni birarali manduno ewa sara celo ngana kai kai ndro ni manduli ni mitel ngama mela mai boitel ngaba kumanduna ba tor daktai
imata himbera na ikau kwa wabukwe etar ndu tarfi mata na linirara edo kwa hewa
imata sinda mbitu nga na ikau kawani ruangan ikau kawani wawandaro kolong-kolong kwe mandu ndawari atu ni besi nga nga bimbo ngeru ndu wawandun rirwalu na ilube seoro na ngasi wumbra ruturu kwa nimbiru tako somaike sekunda ke melebe menalo tuba mata singa ro tasimunda wota ko soreo walu rulele oturewa si singa no ngamir wota ko solista ini bo boina wa bulu ko singa bungi woron le wota nga bua ko kunda ko kacia mo ngwata no na tako soni ke yerewa
ke usu sumboto ngada mune mela hiro mbale mana minsta min dolavia mi tolavia munina lenju rara ko na bukeli
ya go o vaoka kavali buna la siro manatura nga minista mandumbu kawita ki tumuni mana no tia chonda ki pena longa ni kai kai se na ben tenda ko ni vira rali mandunu mi atunga ni iba torda ka ta ki mandu tola batunga bo bango li tunga mana vira rali bu na bi bachinga ni gale bu le bu na highway ninge kila chani ko ni mandu kawita ki tumuni na no ko tona tia longa ni kai kai na bola mai batu kana sarati ko na nabi ko amandu o ka ngandri batu mela mai batu rek tal ngan ta ke tal ngan ke na le mandura
na boli ba
ko le na ba ko